Good morning, students. In the last class under morphology of flowering plants, we studied a dicot family, Solanaceae, with few examples like tomato, potato, chili, and so on. Solanaceae, dicot family. Today we will continue another family, monocot family, Liliaceae. Monocot family Liliaceae. So few plants of economic importance we'll recall first. Plants of economic importance. Yes, these are few commonly known plants. Two medicinal plants are, one is onion, Allium sepa, onion, Allium sepa, aloe vera. Two medicinal plants under Liliaceae is aloe vera, Allium sepa. Few plants are cultivated as ornamental plant. Tulip, gloriosa, is commonly used in flower bouquets, gloriosa. Plants are vegetable as well as we can use them as food. Colchicum autumnale, Allium sepa, onion, asparagus. Allium sepa and asparagus. These we use as vegetable as well as fruit. Colchicum autumnale, a drug, colchicin, a drug known as colchicin extracted from this plant, which is an alkaloid, used in research, used in cell biology research, like that. So plants of economic importance, so among them I think most of us know these two plants, that is aloe vera and Allium sepa. Now coming to the family characters, characters of the family. So under characters, in the earlier class I explained vegetative characters, then the floral characters. Coming to vegetative characters, under that comes habit, how the plant is, habit followed by stem and then the leaves. So characters, under that first character is vegetative characters. Under vegetative character, first we'll see the habit. Habit is, members are perennial herbs. Members are perennial herbs. Annual, biennial, these are the commonly known terms related to perennial. Annual, those which complete their self life cycle in 1 year are called annual. Those which complete their life cycle more than 1 year are biennial. No. Which complete their life cycle in 2 years are biennial, more than 2 are perennial. So perennial, these are small plants, herbs, but perennial herbs. Complete their life cycle after 2 years, more than 2 years. Then coming to stem. Recall the stem in the case of onion. Three different kinds of stems are seen in this family. So stem is underground. Stem is underground. Bulb, corm, rhizome are the three conditions seen. Bulb, corm, rhizome. Bulb is seen in the case of onion. Bulb of onion. The term we say bulb of onion. No need to study this example. Just if you write stem, underground, bulb, corm, rhizome are seen enough. These are few example. Bulb in the case of onion. Colchicum shows corm and aloe vera shows rhizome. So what is corm? Corm is a swollen underground stem. Usually one of the commonly known vegetable, what we call elephant's foot. In Kannada we call it as suvarnagadde. It is belongs to this group, corm. So corm is a big swollen mass, grows below the soil. Rhizome. Rhizome is also underground stem. Grows horizontally below the soil. One example, commonly known example for rhizome is ginger. But ginger won't comes under this family. Ginger, shunti in Kannada, that is rhizome. So bulb of onion, corm of colchicum and rhizome of aloe vera are few example for stem. These are few terms related to leaves. Leaves are basal. Think of onion plant. Leaves arise at the base. The onion, what we use as food, is a stem, which we call it as bulb of onion. So leaves are basal. Similar to Solanaceae, here also they are without stipule, ex-stipulate. Arrangement is alternate. So what is alternate? Think of, this is monocot. In monocot stem, usually the stem is underground, or when it is aerial, as such there is no woody stem. Leaf bases together form a weak stem, which we call as pseudo stem. In the case of banana, observe, the entire stem, it is not true stem, in the sense it is a pseudo stem, which is produced by the overlapping of sheathing leaf bases, like that. So think of, this is a weak stem which is produced. See, one of the leaf is like this, another leaf comes like this, third leaf like this, fourth leaf like this. So the overlapping of leaves makes a stem. That is, arrangement of leaves is alternate. One, two. One leaf it is on the right side, another one is on the left. Right, left, like that. So that type of leaf arrangement is called alternate. Since monocots, leaves show parallel venation. I told in the case of Solanaceae, leaves, veins in the leaves are network-like, that is reticulate venation, and linear, they are straight, linear in the sense straight. So leaves, basal, ex-stipulate, alternate, parallel or linear, parallel venation, and leaves are linear. Liliaceae, commonly known as lily family, one of the monocot family. Members are perennial herbs. Stem is underground, bulb, corm, rhizome are seen. Members are perennial herbs. What is that? Habit is perennial herb. Stem, underground, bulb, corm, rhizome are seen. Leaves are ex-stipulate, alternate, parallel venation, and they are linear. Thank you. collect the flowers of onion, you will get usually in vegetable shops, and try to observe them. How are the inflorescence under this family? Inflorescence is cymose. So if we see, this is the peduncle. Peduncle is stalk of the inflorescence. Peduncle is a stalk of the inflorescence. So stalk of the inflorescence is with the flowers like this. So flowers are arranged like this. So what is like this means? These are all, think like this, these are all the pedicels of the flower, stalk of the flower. The pedicels of all the flower have same length, and here are the flowers. Here are the flowers. So it occurs in the form of a bunch, in the form of a bunch, and for this shape, that is the filament, pedicels of all the flowers look like they arise from a single point. This type of arrangement is called umbel, and they are arranged in the form of clusters. Such a type of flower arrangement is seen in onion, aloe vera, like the members of Liliaceae. So inflorescence is cymose. Under cymose there are many types. This is a type under cymose, that is umbellate clusters. Flowers are. I'll explain the flowers. After explaining all this, it will be clear to you. That is, flowers here are bisexual. A single flower possesses both androecium as well as gynoecium. Flower shows actinomorphic symmetry, exactly similar to the family Solanaceae. Bisexual, actinomorphic, can be cut into two equal halves by a vertical section passing through any plane. So what are monocots? While explaining the term perianth, I told, perianth is a term usually seen in monocots. So what is perianth? In the case of dicots, we can see in flower two parts, accessory part, calyx and corolla. Outer whorl is calyx, inner whorl is corolla. Calyx is made up of individuals called sepals, corolla is made up of individuals called petals. Whereas when we see monocot family, we can't distinguish between sepals and petals. The whorl, both outer whorl, inner whorl, entire whorl is called by the name perianth. So whorl, for example, corolla is a whorl. Individuals of corolla are petals, like that. Whorl is perianth, and the individuals are called tepals. Tepals. That means here there is no usage of words like sepals, petals. Instead, the word is tepal. Tepals together make the whorl perianth. In few flowers, perianth is green. In few flowers, perianth is colored. That is, perianth, when it is green, it is called sepaloid. Sepal-like. When it is colored, it is called petal-like or petaloid. So what is perianth? Perianth. In monocot flower, there is no distinction between calyx and corolla. Entire whorl is called perianth. How many? Totally the tepals are 6. In the family, tepals are 6. Totally the sepals are 6. Arranged in two whorls. 3 plus 3. Outer whorl 3, inner whorl 3. In few cases, they are free. In other cases, they are same. Perianth, 3 plus 3, 6, but fused. So in different members we can see two types of perianth. What is that? Perianth 6, tepals 6, arranged in two whorl, inner whorl, outer whorl, 3 plus 3. But in some cases those tepals fused, inner whorl fused with the outer. So P, 3 plus 3, fused condition. Free as well as fused condition is seen in the family. So inflorescence is cymose. Inflorescence cymose, umbellate clusters. Flowers are bisexual and actinomorphic. Bisexual and actinomorphic. Perianth, tepal 6, arranged in twirl 3+3. Androecium, that is flower is bisexual. So how the androecium are? Stamens 6. In few members, this is an exception similar to here, two conditions are seen, perianth free, perianth fused. So usually 6, arranged in a single circle. In some cases, they are arranged in two circles, twirls. Inner 3, outer 3. Stamens attached to the perianth lobes. I already explained this. In few cases, in dicots, stamens attached to the petals, epipetalous. When stamens attached to the perianth, epiphyllous. Yes, here stamens are attached to the perianth lobes. Stamens are attached to the perianth lobes. Term is epiphyllous, that means androecium connected to perianth, which is shown by drawing a curved line upon them like this. So stamens 6, in few cases they are arranged in two whorls, 3+3, attached to the perianth lobes, epiphyllous, C connected to A. Tricarpellary, and the three carpels are fused. Tricarpellary syncarpus. Inside ovary is with three locules, trilocular. I already told, often the number of locules indicate the number of carpel. So how many locules? Three. That means it is tricarpellary. Ovary superior. Ovary topmost position, hypogynous condition. Ovary superior. All the other whorls arise below the ovary. Ovary superior. Placentation axile. Placenta forms the central axis upon, to which the ovules are attached. Yes. Gynoecium, we can represent how? Gynoecium, tricarpellary, syncarpus, trilocular, ovary superior. Seen capsule as well as berry. Capsule seen in the case of onion, as well as berry seen in the case of lily. Seeds are endospermic. Thank you. So recall in short, up to seed again. How the habit under vegetative character? Habit, perennial herbs. How the stem? Underground, bulb, corm and rhizome. How the leaves are? Leaves are alternate, linear, parallel venation, estipulate. And how it is the inflorescence under floral character? Cymose, umbellate clusters. Flowers are bisexual, actinomorphic, perianth lobes. 6, arranged in tuples. In few cases they are fused, in other cases they are free. Androecium stem in 6, arranged in one whorl. In few cases they are arranged in two whorls, 3+3. And filaments are attached to the perianth. Epiphyllous, filaments are attached to the perianth lobes. A connected to P, perianth lobes. That is androecium, gynoecium, tricarpellary, syncarpus, trilocular, showing axile placentation over a superior. Fruits are capsules, commonly seen Allium sepa, onion capsule, very rarely berry in the case of lily. And seeds are endospermic. Yes, this is the floral formula of family Liliaceae. Bracteate, so in this family in your textbook bracts are included, try to write bracteate, actinomorphic bisexual, P 3+3 means what? Tepals, 6, arranged in tuple. The same thing can also be represented like this also. This is also correct. At the same time, if you represent like this, is also right. This is also right. Here, they are free. That is the meaning. So, in members, tepals occur free as well as tepals occur fused. Androecium stem in 6. This condition is also right. At the same time, if you write this condition, that is also right. 3+3, okay, this is also right. Gynoecium tricarpellary syncarpus. Gynoecium tricarpellary syncarpus. Now coming to the floral diagram. So when we draw the floral diagram, what we draw in the center? The gynoecium, followed by we draw the androecium. After that we draw the sepals and the petals. Whereas here we draw perianth. Here we draw perianth like this, and at the bottom we draw the bract. At the bottom we draw the bract. So what is bottom? Bottom is anterior side. What is top? Top is the posterior side. So this represents the mother axis. The posterior side represents the mother axis. Thank you. See the floral diagram. Next is the floral diagram. So what is that? Start from the mother axis. Mother axis, which side? Posterior side. This is the bract. Exactly opposite to this, on the anterior side is the bract. Now, perianth. How I explain perianth? Perianth occurs in two conditions. One is 3 plus 3. 3 plus 3, free. So that is this. See, 1, 2 and 3. These are the three tepals which forms the outer worm. And 1, 2, 3. Three more tepals which form the inner worm. Which form the inner worm. No fusion. No fusion. At the same time, this perianth can also occur 3 plus 3 fused. How to show fused condition? I'll mark with another color to show the fusion. This end fused with this, whereas this end fused with this. This end fused with this, and this end is fused with this. This end fused like this, and this end fused like this. See the union. So if you start from this end, you can observe 1, 2, 3 and 4 together. It forms a tube like the structure. This union is nothing but this union. So when the perianth lobes are united, they form a structure like this. So P3 plus 3 united. Now coming to stamens. Stamens occur in two conditions. Totally 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6. In few cases they are arranged inner whorl, outer whorl, exactly similar to the perianth. Outer 3, inner 3. In some cases, together one whorl like this. And they are epiphyllous. See, it is attached to the tepals, attached to the stepal. 3 are attached to the outer tepals and 3 are attached to the inner tepals. Gynoecium, ovary, superior tricarpellary, trilocular, syncarpus showing axile placentation. Yes, this is trilocular showing axile placentation. Same thing I'll explain from the chart. This is one of the member which I explained as food vegetable, asparagus. The plant is like this. Perennial herb, it is a perennial herb. These are the cluster of flowers. So what are flowers? Flowers are umbellae clusters, a single flower. See, all these are what? The perianth, the tepals. All these are the perianth. 1, 2, 3, 3 more on opposite side. And these are the stamens, totally 6. And tricarpellary, see the stigma is 3. Tricarpellary, syncarpus, ovary. Here you can see, what is the placentation? Placentation is axile. Stamen is with two chambers, anther lobes, axile, placentation. The same diagram is here. Observe. Bracteate, floral formula, bracteate, actinomorphic bisexual, perianth, we can represent in two ways, P3 plus 3 or P3 plus 3 fused like this. Androecium, 3 plus 3, P connected to A, gynoecium, superior ovary, tricarpellary, trilocular. Now observe this. This is mother axis and this is the bract. And these are the outer tepals. The bigger tepals are the outer tepals and the smaller tepals are the inner tepals. Here you can see the stamens arranged in two whorl. See, 1, 2, 3 outer whorl, 1, 2, 3 inner whorl. And in the center, the ovary, tricarpellary. Why? Trilocular condition showing axile placentation. Showing axile placentation. So recall some of the members under this. Allium, sepa, aloe vera, medicinal, ornamental, tulip and gloriosa, and some vegetables are asparagus, colchicum, autumnal and allium sepa. The questions comes usually from this part are like this. Explain the characters of Liliaceae. Try to remember all the characters. Try to write the characters starting from habit to seed. Habit to seed. That is one question usually for 5 marks. With the two examples, correct example with the scientific name, you can write two. Easy example are Allium sepa and Aloe vera. Allium sepa and Aloe vera. One more question is, write the floral formula and floral diagram for Liliaceae. So what is the floral formula? Bracteae, bisexual, actinomorphic. Perianth, 3 plus 3, either free or united, you can write. Androecium, 3 plus 3, you can write, or 6. Gynoecium, tricarpellary, trilocular, superior. Then draw the floral diagram. Draw the floral diagram. You have to draw this diagram. This diagram, refer the textbook again for the diagram. Bract, mother axis, perianth lobe, stamen and gynoecium, and epiphyllous condition. In practicals, one of the family members is given. You have to dissect, and there also two types of questions come. One, you have to write the family characters. Another question, you have to write the floral formula and the floral diagram. After dissecting, you can write, or with the theory knowledge, you can write. So under taxonomy, description of some important families. We studied two families, Solanaceae and Liliaceae. Solanaceae, Liliaceae. Solanaceae comes under dicots, Liliaceae comes under monocots. In your textbook, one more family is included, that is Fabaceae, which is not included this year, the portion which is deleted. So that is, we completed the morphology of flowering plants. Thank you.